one who came from heaven, the Son of Man. My dear brothers and sisters, in the Gospel today, we read about the people who see the world with purely worldly eyes. John the Baptist says to his disciples, "The one who comes from above is above all." The phrase "above all" points towards Jesus, who came from heaven and is above all, or in other words, to say he is superior and preeminent one. There are two reasons why Jesus is above all. Firstly, Jesus' origin is from above. He was not earthly as we are, but he was from heaven. We were born of a man and woman, but Jesus was not. He was from God himself. Secondly, man who is from earth speaks of earthly things, but Jesus spoke not only about earthly things, but also of heavenly things. One who is from earth, when he speaks of heavenly things, he is just sharing his idea and speculation, but one who is heavenly will speak of what he has experienced. And John 3:13 states, "No one has gone to heaven except the one who came from heaven, the Son of Man." Even 1 Corinthians 15:47 gives testimony to these words, saying, "The first man was from the earth, a man of dust. The second man is from heaven." But we are reluctant to accept the message of heavenly things. This is because people look the world only with worldly eyes. We should start observing the world not only as material thing, but also as spiritual. Even people during the time of Jesus could not believe the heavenly things that Jesus was speaking to them. Nowadays too, we find people reluctant to believe in the testimony of people who speak about heavenly things. Though they not being from heaven, they are ones who are given the revelation by God. We have priests, people with gifts of vision and prophecy, and so on. Are we ready to listen to these people? Pharisees felt Jesus' teaching as nonsense. Do we do the same? Therefore, let us pray today that the Lord may provide us a heart and mind to listen to those who give us advice and think good for us. Amen.